Hello, everyone. My name is Chad Hart. I'm an extension economist at Iowa State University. And here in November, USDA released a couple of reports over the past couple of days. They give us not only an update on what we've seen with this year's crops, but they've actually given us their first preview as what they see setting up next year as we look deeper into 2025 and 2026. And I'm going to share that outlook with you here today. Now, as we're looking at the numbers that USDA put out there for us, like I say, they were updating what they saw with this year's crop. And one of the biggest things we were watching for was how they were going to incorporate the losses from the flash drought that we saw over the course of the last, especially month of the growing season for our crops. But we also saw those two big hurricanes hit the southeast and the damage that was done there. Now, in the case of corn and soybeans, while there's not a lot of production down there, it does bring up concerns about just, you know, how much damage was done to the southern crops due to those as well. And so those all got incorporated into the outlook that we're seeing now. So let me start you off with what we're seeing within the corn market. And as we're looking at corn, the idea is what USDA found as they looked at this year's crop was they did see the impacts from the drought. They ended up lowering the yield by about 7/10 of a bushel. That ended up pulling about 61 million acres out of production. So you see now the production for 2024 is set at about 15.14 billion bushels. So it's down about 200 million bushels from what we grew last year, but still a very sizable crop. And in terms of the demand side of the equation, they really didn't move things at all when we're looking at the 2024 column there. The idea is they held everything firm there. So we're left with record usage, but we're still staring at, you know, production that's been exceeding that. And in the grand scheme of things, all this did was sort of tighten down ending stocks a little bit, but they're still growing. As you look at ending stocks for 2024, they're estimated at just over 1.9 billion bushels. So we're now below two, which is good to see, but we're still growing those ending stocks, and that's continuing to put downward pressure on prices. Now, USDA did maintain their price estimate at $4.10 a bushel as we looked at this year's crop. But now as we look forward into next year, like I say, USDA gave us that first initial look there as well. And what they see is more acres coming into beans, mainly because we're seeing, you know, lower prices across the board, across the crop sector. And corn is seen as a better option looking into next year than some of those other crops. So they're adding about 1.3 million acres there. They're bringing us up to 92 million acres. Trendline yield sits at 182 bushels per acre. So when we put those two together, what we get is the potential for another 15.3 billion bushel crop. Not quite a record, but not that far off of it either. Now, looking at total supplies, that's going to take us to well over 17 million bushels being available in the market when we get to next harvest. So that's a lot of corn to work with there. As we look at usage, again, we're at record levels today. They see us continuing to build on those record levels as we move forward, but that growth won't be enough to handle the sheer supplies that we've got here. We're looking at feed demand maybe going up another 100 million bushels. We're looking at ethanol demand going up about 25. And we've got exports actually pulling back by 50 here. So while it's growing, we're not getting quite the gain there. And so when we look at ending stocks, those continue to accelerate. And here we are projecting around 2.2 billion bushels of corn left in storage by the time we get to the end of the 25 marketing year. And that's continuing to put that downward pressure on price, with USDA projecting a 390 corn price for next year's corn crop. Now, looking forward with the soybean crop, what USDA found there for this year's crop is they found, again, smaller crop this year than we had first anticipated. They ended up lowering the yield for 2024 by about 1.4 bushels per acre, so down to 51.7, which is just slightly below what we got from the 2021 crop. In fact, when you're thinking about the records for soybean supplies, we often will point back to 2021 because that was the record yield and record production in 2021, and we're just slightly behind it in both as we look at the 2024 crop year. Now, in terms of the usage side here, though, we did see USDA whittling that down as well. They ended up lowering crush demand by about 15 million bushels, lowering export demand by 25 million bushels. So we did see both supplies come down, but also usage go down. In the grand scheme of things, though, we did see a little bit lower ending stock number. In fact, as we're looking right now for 2024, it's estimated the 2024-25 ending stocks coming in at 470 million bushels. That's down about 80 million from where it was just last month. But that's not enough of a change to change the price outlook here. USDA held its 2024 number at $10.80 a bushel. That's well down from what we've had the last couple of years. Looking forward into 2025, USDA says we're going to see some area come out of soybean production. They're estimating a drop of 2.1 million acres there, down to 85 million in total. Trendline yield at 52.5, so that's going to lead to another big soybean crop, but not quite a record crop again. As we're looking forward, we're expecting 4.42 billion bushels in next year's crop. So we're again looking at sizable supplies. In fact, as we look at total supply in 2025, estimating around 4.9 billion bushels, that would be a record amount of soybeans available within the U.S. soybean market. As we look at the demand side for 2025, USDA continues to see growth in soybean crush, building up by about 65 million bushels as we continue to build those soybean crushing facilities across the country. And USDA does believe that exports could continue to climb here, looking for about a 60 million bushel gain there. So we will see record potential usage for the 2025 crop. But again, it's not enough to really eat away at those, not the combination of production and leftover supply. Now, ending stocks do go down a bit. That's sort of the glimmer of hope here as we're looking at the soybean market, where we're looking at those ending stocks maybe dropping a little bit down to 435 million bushels. But just given the sheer dynamics within the market, USDA is projecting that season average price remaining low at $10 a bushel as we look out for 2025. Now, in looking at how we sort of got here, looking at this year's crop, again, what we sort of saw USDA do was pulling down yields pretty well across the nation, either due to drought or hurricane conditions hitting the production right at the, you know, tail end of the grain fill season. As we're looking here in Iowa, they did end up lowering our yields here by a bushel per acre. We're still looking at a record of 213 bushels per acre on average, but that's a little lower than what we expected just last month. Same thing happened as you look at Illinois, where they lowered them down by actually 4 bushels per acre. So you did see them make some cuts, but again, overall, we're still looking at a record yielding crop on the corn side. For soybeans, the cuts were a little deeper here. Iowa had been projected at record soybean yields as well. Now that's no longer the case. We fell just slightly below the record. But as you're looking across the entire nation, a very strong production year still as we looked at 2024. Now, that strong production year, we needed some growth in the demand sector. Where we've been seeing it over the last couple of weeks has been the export market for both corn and soybeans. This is looking at soybean export sales so far this year, that red line as you're looking there. And you can see that it has picked up over the last 2-3 weeks, especially in comparison to the pace we had last year. And it's starting to approach the black line on this chart, which is our 5-year average. So the soybean market is trying to gain some momentum, get up to that average level, but that's going to be the challenge as we look forward this year. And in fact, as USDA looks at their projections right now, they're saying we won't get back to average, maybe not until late into the next marketing year. Now, in terms of where we're falling short in those sales, it remains still in China, but we've also seen Mexico pull back a bit. But, you know, the encouraging news here is that we are seeing growth in Europe. We're seeing growth in the Middle East. And one of the things I'll be watching here is that unknown bar there when you're looking here at unknown destinations. Usually in the soybean market, those end up heading into China. So we could actually be seeing China buying more into the U.S. market than they have over the past couple of years. And that would be a good sign for the soybean market. Now, for the corn market, we have seen an even larger increase in export sales over the past 3-4 weeks. As you can see here, we're not only running ahead of average pace at this time of year. We're approaching our record level as far as number of export sales at this early in the marketing year. And what's been leading the charge is basically everybody. We're seeing increased sales in Latin America and Southeast Asia, and you can see especially in those unknown destinations. So again, China could be a big player here because not only was the US dealing with some natural disaster problems with the flash drought and with the hurricanes, but we've seen problems within the Chinese production industry as well. And so that could be facilitating some additional sales here as the US has wrapped up its harvest season. And as we're looking at soybean, or I'm sorry, corn sales so far this year, we're up about nearly 50% compared to last year's pace. So it's a really good sign that we hope continues to manifest itself over the coming weeks and months. Now, in terms of what we're seeing in terms of pricing from the futures market, I would say the market is more optimistic when it comes to the corn side of the ledger. You know, again, looking back at USDA's tables, they had the 2024 crop at $4.10 a bushel. 2025, they had it $3.90. As we sit here on November 8th, the futures market for corn basically said 2024. Well, I'm pricing it in about 4.25, so about 15 cents higher than what USDA was saying. And as they look out to 2025, they were pricing that even more positively as we look out there, approaching nearly 450 a bushel. And I think the biggest difference between the two outlooks there is where people think acreage is going. In this case, USDA is adding to that corn pile out there by adding additional acres here. I don't think the market has necessarily factored that many acres in coming into corn yet here. And I think that's a big difference as we're looking here. I think the other big thing here could be the pace at which we're seeing those exports grow and can that continue as we move over the coming months. One of the biggest challenges will be as we look forward, as President-elect Trump takes over in January, how does that change the export picture, especially if he does carry forward on his campaign promise to put tariffs in place, which could damage the opportunities here for corn and soybean exports. Now, as we look at the soybean futures case here, in this case, I would say the markets are more pessimistic about soybeans than USDA is. As you think back, USDA had for 2024 crop 10.80 and for 2025 crop $10. So we look here, futures are at basically $10 for both crops. And I think a lot of that negativity from the future side here is that we're not seeing quite the growth on the export side that we had hoped for soybeans, although it could be building as we look out there now. But I think the other challenge here is, especially as we look towards 2025, is that if we do continue to see very strong production on the soybean side, we're going to need growth from somewhere, whether it's from exports, specifically through China, or whether it would come from soybean crush. The market is definitely looking for utilization to come from somewhere because our production has been incredible over the past 5, 6, 7 years. And so that's sort of the situation we find ourselves in as we look right now. When USDA is looking at what we're seeing here, like I say, what they're seeing is a combination of really strong production this year, despite some of the problems, and the anticipation that we could do that again as we look forward to next year. With that, I want to thank you for your time and patience in watching these videos. Again, my name is Chad Hart. I'm an extension economist at Iowa State University. Thank you for your time.